Are you guys ready to start now?
Yeah. We can't use that as a cold open now.
No, we could use part of it. Part You'd have it. To cut it, though.
Can we? We can beep it.
Because Brim lost his mind. He
wants to use the beeps.
I just beep, beep it. People be like, what the fuck did he say?
That would be funny if I we just random.
Contextually, they'll figure it out probably.
Yeah. Yeah. We should just bleep like a random word in one and see if anybody would be like, what the hell did they bleep for?
Or bleep it ourselves. If you would just beep with a beep, beep and a beep with a beep.
They're like, why are all the beeps different?
it's like on...
Our budget for beep noises is huge.
It's just me.
Your palms are so hairy.
Excuse me?
And we're recording.
Hey, everybody, and welcome to episode 14 of the Cogpod. Is that
right? Even know.
Is it 14?
Yeah.
I think it is. I was unsure, too, though.
Today we have myself, we have Lucas, we have Nick, and we have Grim. We're not doing the roundtable thing anymore, Grim. You missed that last week. You're only going to tell me if you did something super cool.
He was watching, though.
I don't think he was paying attention.
No. Well, if you were. I tuned in slightly late.
Slightly. Only
the round table thing was kind of awkward sometimes anyway.
It was, because I didn't have shit to talk about. Like, I don't have anything I did this week. Did anybody do anything cool? No.
I played Destiny.
I've been sick, so.
That's it then.
I actually got back into
it. I mean, legally, there's only some things we can talk about, so.
Wow.
No, prostitutes.
Prostitutes.
Yeah. Nick, you're a prostitute?
It's a side job.
Sometimes I need a Tim Hortons coffee real bad.
I gotta pay the bills. Oh man, I saw a news article that somebody posted that some dude ran a Zamboni into a Tim Hortons
up from the street. What was he doing with it?
Like,
on the street?
He was on his way home from work, I guess. And
who drives a Zamboni in Zamboni car in Canada?
Canadians. All right, hold on. I gotta find this. You guys keep going. I'm gonna find this.
So while you're looking that up,
they don't drive the Zamboni's home. I'll guarantee that.
That's what I was going to say. It doesn't drive on cement.
It's icy.
Something.
No, it's icy.
I do have a true Tim Hortons story, though, that happened last week as well. And this sounds more outrageous. A guy was at Tim Hortons with his dog, and a cougar attacked his dog, and he fist fought it, punched it in the face, and saved his dog.
Wow.
Yeah.
How's the cougar?
The cougar's not so good because the person who owned the cougar, you're not allowed to own cougars.
Wait, it was somebody's...
Wait, so...
There's more
There's
layers.
There's so many problems.
There's more layers to this story.
I know. Only in Canada.
Somebody owned the cougar as a pet.
Yeah, they smuggled it from the U.S., no less.
Wow.
They stole your cougars.
Wow.
It's like cougars.
It's like an archer when they have the ocelot. And he gets in trouble for having the...
What was the ocelot's name?
Babu.
Babu.
Yeah. Is that Babu? So I found the story. Pete Canadiana. I don't know why.
What the hell
Canadiana.
Does that mean?
Apparently that's like Canadian culture. Is that like Americana?
Is that his last name?
Canadiana. Alberta man.
Is that his
name? No.
No.
It's saying this is like if you would say this is like the peak of Americana. This is
peak. The peak of Canadiana.
Canadiana. Yeah. Alberta man. Yeah. Take Zamboni through Tim Hortons drive-thru. Jesse Myshak had to drive his ice surfacing machine home, and he made a pit stop along the way. So he stopped
There's
at a Tim
pictures.
Hortons. Yeah.
There's pictures
really?
Of him doing it.
Yeah. Yeah. Most Canadian thing ever.
Wow. We can post those later.
Oh, that's awesome.
See that.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. So anyway, the executive producer for this week is Sir Wasabi Shaw.
Wasabi?
Oh,
he made
us
our cool shirts that we'll link to, our Cogpod shirts, and then he made me like a special Otterdoked 8 shirt for my Christmas present.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I do want to read one thing from that article real quick before we go on.
What?
It says, he has no complaints about the level of traction out on the roads. She's got studded tires, so it cruised along quite well, actually. She goes pretty slow, and it's quite cold. you guys.
Canadians,
Wasabi's a Canadiana too.
Yeah.
Yep.
He's a super nice guy. He's always doing stuff for us.
He does. He's always made, he's made 2 hats for me and now 2 shirts.
He's going to fill your entire wardrobe.
Soon.
Soon, TM. Did you say TM at the same time I did?
Yes.
Are you guys going to make any kind of... This is the New Year's podcast, for those of you not looking at it by date, New Year's Eve. Are you guys going to do any kind of New Year's resolutions this year? Anybody?
I can't remember anything that I say I'm going to do tonight. Ever.
Write it down.
Take a note.
I'll lose the paper. Wow. Or hand.
That's just an excuse.
No, I just can't do it.
What about you?
I kind of want to ride a bike this year.
Excuse me?
Just like once, like, or...
No, like frequently.
Like a bicycle or a motorcycle?
I want to ride a bicycle to the market. I watch this cooking show called Cooking with Jun. And he lives in Japan, and he always gets on his bike with a little basket on the front and goes to get ingredients and bikes him back. Like, I want to do that.
Canada, not Japan.
Yeah, I was like, that's fine and dandy in Japan, but you know, the 37 days a year when you can ride a bike in Canada, you know,
I'm a big guy. I don't think I could do more than 37. So.
That'd be an accomplishment more than zero, right?
Yeah, that's right. So that's my one.
Well, that's cool. What about you, Grim? Are you actually going to make one this year, or are you just going to not do it at all?
I mean, I never do. My throat's a little froggy. I wanted to, but then I'm like, you know what? I just forget because I don't care.
What did you want to make one of?
I should say drink more, but...
Wow.
Luke,
no, so you're basically going to kill yourself then.
I guess try to take care of myself a little better.
Well, that'd be good.
That's kind of what ours is. Ours is more generic, like just typical. Eat better, get healthier. Like,
yeah, but the problem, if you make generic ones, you don't stick to them because you're like, oh,
it's more broad. You're more likely to.
There's more leeway, so you know.
We could all ride bikes. Should we get like a 4-person bike and ride it around town?
That'd be awesome.
We'll just on like a GoPro.
I'm gonna just let you pedal.
Aw, it's romantic, you guys. Like you're dating. But no, we want to get healthier. We're just going to do... Are you going to shave your beard or you're not?
Well, as of right now, the poll says yes to shave it and let it grow for a year. And Amanda's...
Explain what a year is.
What's the poll at?
Last I saw it was like 2-1 shave it. It's like 67% to 33%. There's like 18 votes that...
Not a lot.
I'm going to find it upsetting.
I know, me too. That's
like, I'm going to put a post-it note over your screen next time we...
What am I supposed to do? I can't put a post-it note over his entire face in person.
It'll grow back in a week, Amanda.
It will grow back in, you know, to a respectable level in probably about a month.
Note to men that do not have a beard. Grow a beard.
Grow a beard.
Otherwise, you're a lady.
So, we're not sponsored or anything, but I started using this Dollar Beard Club. And my idea was to chronicle growth for a year and do a full, they call it a year. It's a year growth of no trimming, no shaving, no nothing.
But I saw some pictures of the dudes where they didn't trim their mustache at all. It's terrible.
Well, we can kind of play that by ear. But if you want like a true challenge yeared, you know, if I'm going to chronicle it on YouTube every month.
I'm just saying.
I know. I can manage it. And the
you
products...
can manage to also handle your other business by yourself then if it looks terrible.
But, yeah, I mean, I'm a little apprehensive about shaving it because I've had it for over a year now and I look 12 without a beard.
Legit.
Like you saw, actually, my little creeper picture on our website.
Your picture that's still just, your picture on the website because you didn't take a new one yet?
I should probably get a real picture on there at some point.
Up to present, I still wasn't sure if it was you because I've never seen like that.
It was me. It was from Halloween a couple years ago, 3, 4, or 5 years ago now.
It looked awful.
Yeah, it was awesome. It was just a little mustache
I
creeper.
I said awful, not awesome.
Yeah, I heard you. Awesome. And but I don't – I've had the beard since No Shave November last year, actually. When I started, because I shaved like Halloween last year, and I've had it since then.
Was that when you had your hair long and you shaved and cut your hair off?
Yeah, the hair long. Also, I actually have a picture before and after that. Maybe we'll post.
Oh, we got to see that then.
Yeah, it was.
How do you feel about this beard thing, Amanda?
Yeah,
I don't want him to shave it. The end.
Yeah,
You're not looking forward to being in a same-sex relationship, I guess.
No, I'll just go stay with my friends for like a week and a half till it grows.
I'm being real harsh about this beard thing. I just don't want you to do it. But
I know.
Wait, so Nick, was I a lady before?
Yeah. Yes.
You looked like a 12-year-old.
Yeah.
No, I looked younger because if Luke looks 12, then I must have looked 9.
Oh, it's true. No, but if I do shave it, it will be for science, for the purpose of growing back and doing, you know, the chronicling of it with the products and
hey, you'll be supporting them too.
I will be. Maybe they'll pick it up and sponsor it throughout the year. That'd be
maybe
cool.
Maybe they'll scratch your back if you scratch theirs first.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
Yeah. Speaking of, you did a poll.
Yeah. No, go ahead.
I did a poll also because I feel like I'm over Nina Dobrev now. Like, she's too famous and doesn't care about anyone but herself. I hope she does. Get humble. Come on. But anyway, so I did a poll to pick a different girl crush. And so the winner, it closed today. And if I add all those votes to the other votes, the winner is Rachel May Taylor, which is the blonde chick from Jessica Jones.
Yeah, you had a lot on Instagram that voted for her.
Well, and my friends IRL voted
That's
for
her.
That's true. Wait, you have friends?
Shut up. But on the Twitter poll, they all liked the redheaded chick from Rose Leslie from Game of Thrones.
Yep.
But that's like hard to do side-by-side pictures of one redhead versus another.
Yeah.
It seems a little weird.
I don't think you'll see much of her anymore anyway.
Don't spoil it. No spoilers.
No. Okay. I mean, she's just going to be typecasted, right? I think you just spoiled
Possibly.
It.
Possibly.
Oh, that's probably true.
I haven't seen it,
so I don't know.
We don't know what happens.
We're like 4 seasons behind.
She's totally fine. It's all right.
God dang it. last we saw was about when she was telling Jon Snow he knows nothing.
You know nothing.
Yeah. And he proved her wrong.
He sure didn't. Wasn't that like his first time? Nobody proves anybody wrong on your first time.
Right. No. That wasn't his first time doing what he did to her. Remember, he had done other things.
Ew, just stop.
Just think how long he'd been without showers with all those furs on.
You know, I used to want to live in like medieval times until I started thinking how smelly everyone probably was.
Oh, man.
It's right. Everyone smelled, Nick.
Yeah, but that doesn't make it right.
No, it does not.
Everybody smells. You know, that was the song back then.
I'd be the medieval guy who lives next to a river for sure. So.
Yeah.
And doesn't, you'd live and doesn't in the waterfall. Visitors. Yeah.
I wonder if there were, like, clean freaks back then.
You know? There was. Nostradamus. He treated people for the plague and never caught it because he was the only man washing his hands.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a true story, maybe, not a...
Maybe he foresaw... and
I would be fine.
I'm not gonna claim that he knew the future, but I'm gonna claim that he did wash his hands, so
yeah.
That were you there?
I was.
Nick is a Highlander. Have you seen him?
Old
he's
Nick.
A vampire.
Old Saint Nick. Wait, what?
Well,
wait, he's a vampire and Highlander?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot.
It's a long story, guys.
If I was a vampire, I would probably be Highlander. Be a
I don't think
also.
That's a thing.
Why? I mean,
is it a profession or
couldn't
a race?
You just choose to be? No, it's a Highlander is a.
You can't choose to
not
be
really
Highlander.
Either. It's like a status thing. It's like a.
It's,
there can be only
hard
one.
To say because they got rid of Highlander 2, like that don't count anymore.
Well, there was, you know, the canon of it was almost like a tournament, I guess. You know, like you had to search out the other immortals and try to become the last one. You know, that's why
all I remember is a scene in like
what the fuck?
a
Mario Van Peebles,
a garage, like a
yeah, like garage. A parking garage.
That's the only thing I remember from that.
Yeah, they were fighting. It was Chris. Well, what was his name, guys?
Christopher Lambert.
Lambert, thank you, and
or Adrian Paul if you like the TV show.
Oh, and then Sean Connery as a Spanish man, quote unquote, air quotes.
Bless it.
With a Scottish accent, Spanish man.
Terrible.
And it was good stuff. It was classic.
Anyway.
How did we get that far off track?
I have no idea. You guys just kind of barreled down.
We were talking about New Year's resolutions.
I don't know how you got to Highlander from New Year's resolutions. But anyway.
Yes.
So we looked up like some statistics or like top 10 resolutions typically. So we can just kind of, I mean, those are pretty obvious. Like lose weight.
Yeah.
get organized, spend less, save more, enjoy life to the fullest. What the fuck
does these are the most mean? Generic freaking, like, oh, how do you quantify these? You know?
Staying fit and healthy, yeah. Like, that's one. That's... Learn something exciting. Like, what the?
Yeah. Quit smoking, help others in their dreams, fall in love, spend more time.
Like, quit how... smoking's a good one.
Yeah, though. Quit smoking and, like, lose weight, getting organized.
But the rest are of about them are generic the as fuck.
All those others aren't quantifiable. That's the problem. Like, goals have to be measured, easily obtainable, and quantifiable. Like, you have You have to be able to measure progress in them. And most of those are just completely abstract, you know? It's like, enjoy life to the fullest. What does that mean?
Nobody keeps
I love seeing
anyway.
Those posts always on Facebook. Living life to the fullest on Facebook.
Hashtag I don't know if that's
and then the next day they're complaining.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's called bipolar. A lot of people have it. We, you know, everybody has it to a degree, I believe.
Mostly, anyway.
Yeah, I mean, and that's just a fact that people have.
Everybody
ups and
has
downs.
Mood swings.
Yeah, just depends on to the degree of them and how debilitating they are, and how manic you get, and how depressive you get.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm fine.
Shut up. Nick's just manic.
Just happy.
Nick's just a I'm happy cool. guy.
I wish
you are,
I was
actually.
Manic all the time. Get a lot more shit happy. Done.
Yeah. We got
so,
some stats, though.
I'm going to tell you this.
Psychotically happy.
Psychically happy. Christ.
Percentage of Americans. So this is Americans, apparently.
Sorry.
Who usually make New Year's resolutions is 45%. And then of that 45%, people who are successful is 8% of the 45%.
No, 8% total.
No.
Yeah, percent of people who are successful in achieving their resolution.
But that's only of people that made their resolution.
So is it
like
eight?
If they didn't make the resolution, then how can they be successful?
I don't know. Is it 8% of 45 or 8% of 100? It's very unclear.
I think it's 8% of 45.
So that's like 3.5%.
So not many.
Math.
Not many.
Not many.
Yeah, and 17% infrequently make New Year's resolutions, and 38% absolutely never make you.
I used to be one that did, and then I switched to never, and then this year we kind of were going to make one.
49% have infrequent success, which means sometimes they do, I guess.
It just happens, guys.
And 24% fail every year.
That's then cool. Why keep doing it? A rat learns after 7 times.
Okay, now this little quote bugs me. People who explicitly make resolutions are 10 times more likely to attain their goals than people who don't explicitly make resolutions. So if you don't explicitly make a resolution, how are you going to achieve it? That should be 100% more, not 10 times more likely.
Maybe they mean like they make like a generic, they make a real specific one rather than a generic one.
Well, it was worded poorly if that's the case. Whatever. Which is what we were talking about earlier. It has to be.
It needs to be
concrete and measurable.
You know what I think a New Year's resolution is? It's like today's Friday, and I say I'm starting to diet on Monday.
On Monday,
that's what it is. New Year's is like I'm not doing fuck all till the end of the year.
Oh, we totally do. I'm like I'm not going to drink soda because that's so bad. I've done it for a long time. Like I went a while without drinking it and got back on it again. And I'm like, New Year's, I'm gonna start and not drink soda again. And then I'm like. But that's next week, and I go and get a 44-ounce drink from the corner store. You know, I don't work.
And you're so hopelessly addicted to it by New Year's, you can't stop.
So good.
I don't know how many times I've said in my mind, well, starting Monday, like literally,
yeah.
How many times that sentence has been thought is, it's like, true. I can't count that.
Do you do that, Grim?
No.
No.
He's not a girl that wants to diet.
Grim doesn't sacrifice.
Grim just does it. Grim does it.
That's
he
right.
doesn't yeah, think I about just it. Do it. He just does
Starting
it.
Monday, I'm going to work harder now.
No.
I just.
Or he just doesn't do it. He does or he
I
doesn't.
I just don't That's, do it.
Screw those
he's
people.
He's a binary Grim. He's either doing it or not doing it. That's all there
true.
Is. There's no Monday.
Not a lot of gray area with Grim.
No.
What's a Monday?
God damn.
That's like your Thursday or Friday.
Friday.
So this week, you guys, basically we have like a bazillion questions.
Woo!
And that's all we really have to, we don't really
thank
have
you,
actual
fan.
Or is it one question with a bazillion answers?
It's both. So from, let's just jump in because we have so many.
There was one more thing on that that's hilarious to me. The link that 75%, only 75% maintain the resolution after the first week already. 25% fail within the first week.
Wow.
That is.
Well, it's American.
About right.
That is horrible.
It's America.
America. Yeah.
Are you done now?
Yeah.
I hate Bob Saget. I hope he gets 2016.
Oh.
Wow. Oh, that's rude.
Today's the last day. Someone's going to die.
Come on, Bob Saget.
Just not Betty White, you guys. Not Betty White.
No.
So the first question that we got is from Millie Mozilla.
What's up, Millie?
He wants to know what is the absolute best New Year's resolution you can come up with and actually keep, saying none is not acceptable.
Grim.
Oh, that was specifically for
you. So that's specifically for you, Grim. So we'll come to you last so you have time to think, because none is not acceptable. So to have one that you can actually attain, for me, would be not drinking diet soda. I have to be very specific with my wording.
So just regular soda?
That's fine. I'm just cutting out aspartame. I'm cutting out aspartame.
Loophole. Definitely achievable, I suppose.
That's a loophole. Hey, he didn't say I couldn't be really, really specific.
That's true. But Nick, so are you going to drink regular soda?
Yeah, I didn't say that's what I was doing. He asked if I was to, what would it be?
Oh.
That's not what I said, though.
If you were to.
Yeah, if I was going to. I didn't say that's what it was.
All right. My Nicky Nicky Nicola Nico.
I'm going to eat more yogurt.
So one thing of yogurt.
I already started. So
that is not eating yogurt.
That's not yogurt.
Yes, it is. They just put water in it to make it drinkable.
Oh my! Wait. So is that the is that like the Dan Active stuff? I don't know if you guys have that up there.
Yeah,
is that like the cultures, like the things that are good for your digestive system? Well, things like
they were on for $1, and I had ate a lot of salty food, so I bought like 30 of them. So I'm definitely achieving this goal.
Oh my god.
Only because they were 30. On sale.
See,
that's, you did right. I was so thirsty.
You did the same thing. You did the drink more of something rather than, or you know, there's, it's not quantifiable. It's like, okay, I drank one.
I also
more than
bought a yogurt that had chocolate and praline in it, and I thought, it's gonna be pudding. It wasn't. It tasted like sour. Sour poop or something.
Whoa.
Sour poop flavor coming soon.
Speaking of yogurt, we just had some tzatziki a week ago, and we're talking about we might make our own next time because it's really easy. It's like 4 ingredients.
Yeah, you should.
So good, too. Mm.
Answer the question.
Oh, my beard.
Jesus.
I'm going to grow the beard.
Yeah.
That's really it, or that's what you would say?
No, that's it.
Yeah. You're gonna succeed. Probably.
I mean, it's just gonna grow.
I'm gonna shave
it. It's not a way to fail at
that. I'm gonna shave it and then grow it legit with no picking at it or messing with it or trimming and messing it up. It's gonna be glorious.
All right,
majestic.
And along with that, doing the monthly updates. And Nick and I were talking about this. I think I'm going to do a daily picture of it as well.
Time lapse
it over the whole year at the end of the year. That'd be really
cool. That's the only way I got on board for this project.
Well,
yes.
And you were talking about that.
Just you know, send me a message when it grows back and then I'll come back to the house.
Shut up.
So Graham, did you think of one?
Learn a new language.
Okay.
That's achievable.
What language would you learn?
Well, I've already tried learning Japanese. I just get bored.
That sounds hard. Japanese sounds hard.
No, it's actually really easy and it actually makes sense, unlike English.
Well, I guess that could be true. English is pretty bad.
And from what I've heard, English is the hardest language to learn as a second language because we have so many, what do you call them?
Stupid
exceptions
rules?
To the rules. And no, the rules are fine. It's the exceptions, and nothing makes sense, and it's backwards, and verbs come.
We have a lot of
words
that are spelled the same that mean different things as well.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that makes it difficult.
And the same, like, different spellings for the same word, and
my favorite thing for the English language is loose and lose, and I always see people typing loose.
Oh my god.
Lose,
yeah.
And it ticks me off.
You know, the ironic thing is a lot of times they're like, you're such a looser. And no,
yeah.
You are.
Yeah, that's the best part.
You are. That's why.
You guys ready for the next question?
I don't know. Did everybody get their answer proper?
Yep.
So, Dino.
Right. Baby, now, it's Dino outside.
Yeah, that's his name right now for the holidays. Baby, it's Dino outside.
Oh, on Fallout server, he's Dino's little helper. Or no. Santa's little Dino. Okay. And I'm Dino's little helper on Fallout's chat.
Thanks for that oddly specific
reference.
So Dino wants to know, what are your news resolutions? We already talked about that, but he said, like, in regards to gaming.
Stream more. And actually do those playthroughs of games I haven't played before, specifically.
All I can say is I'll stream more. I'm not even going to get more specific than that, because I'm not going to fucking do it.
Well, we, like, and along with that, record as a group for our Minecraft stuff that we had talked about.
Who plays that? What's Minecraft?
You. We'll see, because every time we fucking start, something breaks.
I'm going to throw eggs at you, Grim.
You already did that.
I think you need a carrot, though.
Yeah.
Those bloopers were funny, the egg throwing bloopers
that,
were funny.
That was a little nuts. That was fun.
What about you guys, gaming resolutions?
Just play some of the games I've bought.
Oh, that's
I guess would be a good one.
Your Steam collection?
God damn Steam.
I never play.
Play 10% of the Steam games that I own.
I got so many that emails sounds... when they had the sale. They're like, this is on sale and this is on sale. I'm like, I fucking know it's on sale.
An item on your wish list.
Stop having a wish list.
Yeah, exactly. That's the problem.
I only did it because people wanted to like send me games. And so they were like, make a wish list so we know what to send you.
Oh, that's so horrible.
That came in handy at Christmas time for a lot of people on my list.
Nice. Yeah.
Grim Gaming.
Beat one game.
Okay. All right.
That's a, you have one in mind?
Lofty goal. No.
I mean, he answered the question.
That's right. Nobody said Pac-Man. It had to be... No. Can you beat Pac-Man? I don't think so.
I don't think so, no.
Doesn't it just infinitely...
I think it just keeps going until you get a high score. New high
Are we
score.
Talking about the like Nintendo 64 Pac-Man?
I don't know.
Can you beat Tetris?
Adventure Pac-Man?
I don't think so. No, Grim, we're not.
Okay, you ready for the next one?
Yeah.
All right, this one is specifically for you, Luke.
What?
I don't know why. Mr. Pitcher 475 would like to know, are there any gaming events coming soon that you're interested in for 2017?
I don't really follow too closely. I usually just watch the big ones for major releases, things like that, like the E3 and EGX and stuff like that. I think that's what it's called. Anyway, E3 mainly.
When is Worlds?
For League, it just happened. It's at the end of the year. Oh. So I do want to kind of get back into watching esports a little bit more, like League of Legends. And other than that, though,
are you
just
playing League?
Maybe. I know. I like watching it more than playing it, I think. It's
that's okay.
Not good enough.
You know?
Not good enough to play.
But yeah, just kind of the major ones for to see the releases and trailers, and you know they always like to build up hype. And I'm sure at this year's E3 they're going to show Destiny 2 off, which will be exciting and hopefully not suck, which I doubt it will.
Not the suck.
Are you, is
speaking
anybody else?
Of esports? No, that was just you.
Okay.
And this one is also just for you.
What?
Oh wow.
What's going
and
on
related
here?
To esports you're from popular. Lazarich. Yeah, you're popular this week. This is from Lazarich. He said that you already talked about esports previously.
Mm-hmm.
But he was talking about the prize pools, and he wants to know, like, what do you think the max prize pool should be? Is it too high, or should it be higher?
I honestly think it's okay, because they basically... I mean, they base them off of the popularity of the game and how much they can give them, you know, based off of, you know, if the game's more watched and draws a bigger crowd, they can give them a bigger prize pool. And so, I mean, it makes sense. I know that...
Which one was the highest again?
Dota 2, I believe, was the big one.
Yeah, it was Dota 2.
Yeah. And that's because it's one of the biggest out there, and Valve has a huge backing behind it and can fund the event, you know, to be a super long event. And bring in a huge crowd and make a lot of money off of it. And so, you know, League is also getting bigger every year. With
Smite.
It's all these MOBAs, you know, that are... Mm. And people like to watch it because it's... Every game's a little bit different, you know. There's reactions and things change. And there's a meta for sure. But, you know, it's exciting to watch. So...
Is it?
Yeah. And it's also more than just like one person playing. Versus another person, it's teams and what are you talking about? Is it
you
like
get personalities
League?
In there?
Yeah. I was watching League. I was referring to Overwatch.
Oh. We didn't talk about shooters. We talked about MOBAs.
I know, but you knew what I was talking about.
Yeah. What about you guys? That one doesn't have to be just for me.
Well, it was directed at you. So? I was reading it just as it was sent.
I'm not selfish. What do you guys think about prize
pools?
I know you don't. What do you guys think about prize pools for them?
I think it's great. I'd like to have it.
Right? I would like to go to there.
I was going to say that.
Yeah. Well, what would the incentive be to do it otherwise? Like, I feel like that causes people to want to do good.
Right. You know, if you become a pro in one of those, that's like your full-time job, you know? And
that's your job. That's your
and income. If they're doing it just for the money and not the joy of killing other players, then I spit on them.
Well, I'm sure that's how they started. And then, you know, you get good enough and you're like, I would love to compete. That'd be cool. That'd be really great. New Year's resolution, become a pro.
Oh, good Lord.
Esports player.
I still recommend Smite. You could probably actually do it in Smite.
I really doubt it.
You don't think so?
No, I'm not that good at games.
Stop trying to convert us.
Right?
Nick really wants us to
play. We do need
Smite.
To play it. I mean, it is free. So
yeah.
Now,
I would like to have a conquest team so people don't yell at me all the time.
In Smite, do you?
Well, maybe you should get good.
Do you buy?
I can't. That's the problem. I'm fucking old. What?
Do you buy in League or in Smite like you do in League? Like
you can
items?
Buy skins and stuff.
No, I mean like during the game, like do you earn gold and buy to
make, oh yes you do.
To make builds.
Yep, there's a whole item meta.
Okay, cool.
I was gonna say that if we were a team we would still yell at you constantly, so I don't know why I think that would help.
The difference but is they only take it seriously from strangers.
Yeah.
Isn't that weird how that works? You get like people get so offended and angry when it comes from a stranger.
I don't. Yeah. I'm the opposite.
Like, I know I do. Like, if I get teabagged in Destiny, it triggers me. And I know they do it to trigger me, and I shouldn't. But I'm like, what the hell? Why is he teabagging me? I didn't do anything. You know, like, oh, I killed the guy with a Nova Bomb or something, you know? And it's like.
But then when your buddies do it, you just like,
drink
another beer.
No, no. The only time I condone teabagging is if they're lagging or cheating, or it seems like they are. Laggers get bags. You know, lags get bags. That's the rule. And then now if somebody dabs on me, I'm going to bag the shit out of them.
Hey, some people can't control how good their internet is, Luke.
Whatever, Grim.
What is
you
dab?
Know, they can still enjoy video games.
How do you dab in a video game?
It's an emote. It's
an
you've got to be kidding
no,
me.
They added
no,
it.
No, I'm sorry.
Way to pander to the fucking 12-year-olds.
People love
it. The stranger thing is, because you'd never be like out in public and a stranger's like, you suck, go kill yourself because...
Yeah!
Because you'd kill them, like you'd just punch them and
right.
That's how people behave. So
I've only got one message that told me to kill myself and I was very... I didn't really get too mad because I'm like, wow.
It's just annoying.
Yeah, I just reply with GG.
It's depressing.
And then they get mad.
Yeah.
It's just
unblock them.
The whole thing's just stupid.
So I recently started playing Battlefield 1.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it is a shooter that I feel like people who are bad at shooters can play.
Oh.
Because you feel like you are not a part of the fight at all because there's like 30 people on your team.
That's true. It's 64 person battles.
I never got.
Yeah. Yeah. So I've had people teabag me, and I'm like, okay, you've killed me once this whole match, and it's almost over. Like,
yeah, they are.
I don't understand.
They do capture that kind of big battlefield where it's, you know, it takes the whole team, one person. I mean, definitely, I'm sure somebody can carry. And
oh yeah,
a huge difference. But
should I make a horrible confession about MOBAs?
What?
That when someone's mean to me in a MOBA, I copy their username, paste it into Google, and try to track them down on other social media.
Oh, Nick.
Jesus.
You're just as bad as me in taking someone's username.
I know. I just want revenge because I think people should be nice to each other.
Grim, did you change your Twitter handle now that you realized you can?
You can't change your at.
What? I showed you can.
No, you can't change your at.
Hmm.
I tried.
Oh. What'd it say?
It's grayed out.
No, I got to the point to where it actually shows like you can type in the box. I'll show you.
That's just your what people see, not your
imagination.
Anyway, I'll show you when we're off here.
I don't believe you. You never actually showed me. You told me.
I show and tell.
Maybe later.
Showers and growers.
God dang it!
Whoa. Whoa.
What? Who is this?
Anyway.
So the next question. Jesus. This one is, like, ridiculous. So this person wanted to know our top 50 PlayStation games. And I was like, I don't think there are 50 even, like, in total.
I'm sure there are, but none of us have played anywhere near that many.
I've only ever played Destiny.
I played, like, maybe 10 or 15 PlayStation 4 games. Yeah, so no, we're not going to give you 50.
I had to think really hard to come up with 5, and I might have made some up. I don't know.
I could give you 5 games in total.
See right there, username.
But all of mine are, like, PC gaming. I don't play on a console. PC Master Race.
That's racist.
No. Woot woot.
Okay, so what do you got?
Am I supposed to answer it?
Okay. Well, yeah, that's the point of the question.
So PlayStation's Destiny. It's the only one I've ever played. But besides that, Minecraft, obviously.
Another good PlayStation game.
Well, it is on PlayStation.
Diablo 3.
Also on PlayStation.
League was okay. I wasn't good enough at it.
Yeah. Spooky cats.
Yeah. I'm so frustrated.
That was the best game ever.
That's the first stream of yours that I watched, actually.
Was it? Oh my god, yeah. You missed out then.
You had Layers of Fear, Amanda.
Layers of Fear was good, but the Tomb Raider stream. Oh, go back and god. Watch those. Man, I raged so hard.
She rage quit.
I like literally quit on stream.
That's funny.
Wow.
So that's mine.
Yeah. Funny is a couple of those were actually original PlayStation games. Like, Tomb Raider was originally on PlayStation 1.
Yes, that's right.
PS1.
Why would have been easier?
Triangle boobs.
Triangle
troops.
Just boom, boom. Yeah. Quality.
Could poke your eyes out.
Yeah.
Nick?
Hey. Jet Li's Rise to Honor. That's one.
What?
But a movie or a game?
No, it's a game. Jet Li made it. Motion captured and voicing and everything. Mm.
What awesome year? Game. What year was this?
12.
You're 12.
It's pretty old. It's an awesome game. I still have gone back and played it.
So
it's like,
far behind always.
Wait, Amanda, you didn't say Tenchu.
I didn't play Tenchu.
Oh, shit.
I watched Tenchu. Oh. But I didn't
all right,
play
I'm
it.
Appending that to my list. Tenchu 3.
I do. I no, it was Tenchu Z. But Tenchu Stealth Assassin. I say it all the time, but I don't know what I'm saying, so I'm not going to do it now.
No.
No.
Oh, they whistle? Do they whistle? Yeah.
No, they don't. I'm not
oh,
doing
they hum,
it.
They hum, don't they?
They're like, And then when they're surprised and they've got like a little
Bling?
Sound over their heads, yeah. I'm not going to say what I think that they say because it's probably not right.
Say
that's
it.
Right. Yeah.
I'm not going to do it.
Anyway, go ahead.
Peer pressure.
All right. So I'm adding Tenchu 3, Silent Hill 2. Shadow of the Colossus.
Oh, yes.
And God of War. There.
Okay.
That's every PlayStation game I've ever played. I love them all. My favorites.
What about you, Grimsby?
I have
he's
to say,
looking around for PlayStation games.
Yeah, it's the one right here.
Titanfall 2, Final Fantasy 15, like the last 5 you've played.
Devil May Cry is... I wouldn't put Final Fantasy 15 on that list.
No. Ooh, was Mirror's Edge a PlayStation game?
Yeah.
Was it?
I think
it was
they made it one.
Okay.
That was good.
Okay.
Sorry.
But I don't know. I enjoy Devil May Cry series, which I... There isn't a new one.
I remember they did the reboot, which was pretty good. But the original...
Wild Arms...
Really good.
I'm just naming PlayStation games because I don't care just for PlayStation 4.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We'll go with Breath of Fire.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Some of the Final Fantasies. I really like Final Fantasy 9 as opposed to 7.
Right. Because you're not a conformist.
Actually, I have never like really played 7. I've seen it played.
I played a little bit of it. I actually own an original PlayStation copy of it. Like with the discs I have.
Actually, with the discs I think I have two.
It's like 4 discs, isn't it? Three.
Yeah, 4.
3 or 4.
It might be 3.
I think it's 3.
A lot of them were 4.
Mm-hmm. And?
This is a tough decision.
That's enough.
Keep thinking. I'm going to go with Demon Souls. Was amazing.
Oh, that is a good one.
Oh, it's so good. PS3. Resident Evil 4. Shadow of the Colossus, also.
Oh, yeah. Awesome game.
That's a great game. Don't cry. Final Fantasy X was a really big one for me. That was kind of what got me like super into Final Fantasy. Because before that, I was just kind of in passing. Yeah. They did the remastered, right? 10 and 10-2?
Yeah.
10-2 was weird.
Okay.
That's like the pop star singing version, isn't it?
Yeah, it was. It was weird.
It was like the first intro to like action combat and being, you're timed on each like mission.
It was kind of strange. They kind of took some chances with that, I think, because it was a spinoff. It was the first spinoff game for a Final Fantasy that was a direct sequel to one of the numbered titles. So it was very interesting.
Are you going to sing 1,000 words for us now?
No.
Can you do that? Can you do it?
No. I'll play some Blitzball.
What is Blitzball?
It's from Final Fantasy X. It was like you're in a water sphere, and it was like soccer, but rugby kind of swimming.
At the same time.
Yeah.
3D soccer or something like that.
It was interesting.
Soccer is 3D. What are you talking about?
Kinda, yeah.
4D? Into time?
And space. What else did I... How many did I say? 3 or 4?
I have no idea. I wasn't paying attention when you were talking.
Destiny, you know, is one of my most played games of all time, so I'm going to have to put that on there.
Do you really enjoy it?
I do. You know, I go through phases where I take breaks from it, but, I mean, I've put way more hours into it than I have in any other game.
Or relationship.
Hey.
Whoa. Called out.
This is getting deep now. If they don't make Destiny 2 for PC, I'm going to write an angry fucking letter. I'm so tired of hearing about this. I'm sure they're not playing it.
I'm sure that's going to make a big difference.
Fucking space D&D.
I don't know how many I said, but yeah, those are probably my top ones. I'm sure I have others as well. God of War was a big one for me. All the first three, I think.
You guys didn't like Devil May Cry?
I did. The original Devil May Cry, I remember, was really good. And after that, they kind of got a little...
Three was okay.
Yeah.
Two was the...
Oh, shit. Fatal Frame.
Oh, my God. Fatal Frame.
How did I forget that? I'm adding that.
Because there's a lot of games.
We're going to get to 50 here soon.
We might do 50. I guess I thought it was like 50 each of us, but...
That's true if we just kind of keep naming.
Redid Fatal Frame for the Wii U, which is kind of cool.
I heard that. I did hear that.
The controller. The concept is kind of neat.
Oh, yeah. Mario Kart 64, Super Smash Brothers. Oh, there's a Nintendo. Sorry.
Yeah.
Zelda. Okay.
They don't have that many games. They don't have 50 games.
Yeah.
Just going to wait till you guys start stop giggling like little fucking girls. Fucking hell.
Well, that's not going to help.
That's not a giggle.
That's their version of a giggle.
No.
They sound like chipmunks
They put their hands over their mouth.
All right, so we have another question.
Okay.
And I can't answer it because I didn't play Pokemon. This is a Pokemon-specific question.
Okay.
From Elastic Armadillo.
Hello.
Hello. So he said that Pokemon was huge this year, but it didn't have a tutorial. So players kind of had to figure it out on their own.
Okay.
And he wants to know if that added to the fun or was more of an annoyance.
Well, I actually think this one was more friendly to the beginners because it tells you things like when a trainer is going to be like on the road, it tells you what trainers are going to attack you or what people, because it has like a little thing above their head, like an exclamation. And then it also tells you while you're in battle, after the first time you fight something, it will tell you if your moves are going to be not effective or not very effective or super effective. So it tells you, you know, exactly what moves are going to be stronger against that particular Pokemon. So, I mean, it lacked like a formal tutorial, but it kind of did the thing that all of them did, you know, where you would, it would give you tips if you talk to people. And so I think that it didn't detract from it at all. And it made it a lot less frustrating if you weren't like a super hardcore, you know, knew all the Pokemons and their types and what the strengths and weaknesses were against all of those. So I think it made it more accessible, actually. Cool. Grim, you're the only one who played it, I think.
Yes, and you're actually correct. I felt like even before I played it, it was super like user-friendly.
Yeah.
Like, that could be your first Pokemon, and you would feel like you've been playing it for years.
Yeah, and I think they did really well with the like the kind of overall flow of it, too. You know, it was polished, and it didn't feel as clunky. Like, it always kind of told you where to go. So it was almost too hand-holdy at some points.
Yeah, because even the map, like,
Pokemon Go, or just the...
Pokemon in general being, like, big this year.
Yeah.
Was there a tutorial for Pokemon Go?
Yeah.
Kind of, but there was a lot of stuff they never explained, and people thought it worked one way, and it didn't, and it worked another, or it didn't work at all.
Yeah.
And I thought that was hilarious.
Yeah, well, people had to figure it out.
Yeah.
That's kind of the way Pokemon's always been, though. You know, it's like, it's branded as this kid's game on the surface, and you can go through and just play the game and have fun and try to catch stuff and, you know, just kind of go through. But there's a layer of depth to it that's really kind of staggering, you know, if you take a look at it with the amount of different, you know, actual just Pokemon you can catch, and their stats vary wildly with, and you can breed them and try to get perfect ones and move sets. And it just goes this whole, like, there's a reason it's been competitive for so long. Like, there's a competitive scene in Pokemon because it's so deep and varied. And
it's kind of adult. I mean, like, when you found out that Ash's parents killed each other.
What? Spoilers.
Spoilers.
I don't.
Just kidding.
What?
Nobody cares.
How they kill each other?
Wait, is Ash Batman, but reverse Batman?
Yeah, he's like, instead of Batman, he's like literally a Batman. No, I don't know. I made that up.
Oh. So, on a side note, it's funny that we're talking about this, because yesterday my brother randomly texted me this. Pokemon Go profited in one quarter for Nintendo $115 million.
Wow.
And for Nintendo's profit during the fiscal year of 2016 before Pokemon Go was $150 million.
Dang. Wow.
Almost doubled him. That's crazy.
That's also surprisingly low, I would think.
Yeah.
But for Nintendo, I feel like that's pretty good.
Yeah.
They've been low for the past few years. I don't know a comparison, but I just thought it was pretty funny he would send me that.
Yeah, I'm sure once the Switch hits, it'll jump up for next year.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that's pretty crazy. Pokemon. And then it fell off a cliff for the next three quarters after that.
Yeah. Anything else about Pokemon?
Pokemon.
What's Pokemon?
Catch 'em all.
I don't know what Pokemon is.
I don't think
is.
So. I mean, I've still been playing and breeding a little bit. I took a little
I
bit
still
time
haven't.
Off this. What?
That can be the one you
games.
Beat.
Hey, you can beat one video game next year. Start tomorrow and finish Pokemon. I mean, I've been doing some breeding still, and this week I played a little bit more Destiny and didn't play as much Pokemon. So I'll get back to it.
You just have two games?
Mainly. I should play like Titanfall 2 and Overwatch. And
oh, you should get the Flame and the Flood.
What?
Have you heard of that game? Flame and the Flood?
No.
Pretty awesome game where the world sort of ended with a big flood, and you're going down like rivers on a little raft, and you got to gather things to improve your raft and survive. And it's got a cool bluegrass sort of soundtrack and stuff. It's real good. You should look it up.
I thought you were going to say it has bluegrass, and I'm like, Nick, you're colorblind.
It may, for all I know.
Damn it.
Are you a little boy, and do you have a person with you on there that is an escaped slave?
No.
I feel like Huckleberry Finn
it's
a
kind
little
of, bit. Yeah, a little bit. Except that's not an apocalypse, I don't think.
It could be.
You're a little girl and you have a dog that runs around and barks at things
that
you might
sounds
eat.
Sounds about right.
Does it make that noise? So.
Just like
that. Yeah, actually.
Luke, you did sounds for this game?
I should voice act for games.
There's a website you can do that on, by the way.
What?
Yeah, you put up some samples and people hire you for indie games to do voices.
Oh, that's cool. I should tell my buddy Jim.
New job.
I should tell Jim about that. And Matt, who do some of our liners.
Yeah, they can make some money.
Put that out there to the people.
We need some more liners, guys. We're going to have to start reusing them soon.
Today.
We're going to play them backwards.
But that's fine. You know, some favorites might sneak in there.
That's fine. I just want people to send in some new ones.
Yeah, it's always fun.
Plus to questions@cogpod.net.
Yes.
And if you don't know what a liner is, that's like a impersonation of a celebrity saying, like, endorsing our podcast.
Yeah. Talking about how much it's great.
And you should listen to it or you suck.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Specifically that, actually.
So the other question that we got that was a top 20, top 50 type question was horror movies.
Oh.
I
love horror movies.
This one's hard in the other direction.
Oh, wait. Did you say horror?
Horror.
Oh, not those.
So obviously I'm not going to write out 20 to 50, but I was like, I'm just going to do 5 and I ended up with 11. So these are in no particular order. I'm also not going to rank them. So.
7.
No, there's 11, I think. Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but not the old one, the newer one with Jessica Biel.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Okay. Lights Out, which is a new one.
Okay.
It's really, really good. Shut In, that I reviewed recently, was really good.
Mm-hmm.
Paranormal Activity, but not the whole series. 1, 2, 4, and 6.
God dang.
Not 3 and not 5. Are you counting those as
separate entries? Or?
Yes. Okay. You're Next.
You're Next.
Am I?
That was a good one.
The new version of Friday the 13th with Jared Padalecki in it.
Okay.
That was good.
You're just like Sam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The Den, which was about a chick that got cyber stalked through chat roulette.
I wouldn't have guessed that at all. I would have thought it would have been like somebody raised by wolves.
Did she get cyber stalked because you made fun of someone in Smite and they found her?
No, it was from chat roulette. You guys know what that is, right?
Was it you?
I've heard of it.
And then the other one that I wrote down was Hush, which was about a deaf chick getting murdered or attempted to get murdered. I'm not gonna tell you how it ends.
Whoa, spoilers.
I didn't tell you which one was.
But she's murdered.
I said attempted.
Yeah.
What about you, Luke? I know you don't really like scary movies that much.
Not a huge horror movie fan.
Horror.
Saw was one that I like, the original Saw.
Only that one. The rest were
awful. I did watch a few of them.
Oh, they were amazing.
And they were bad.
You're an idiot.
You just like the cruelty.
Yeah.
That's the part I can't stand, actually. I like slashers, which is fine, but whenever you torture someone,
torture's
that
rough.
Gets to me.
It's rough. Thrillers more than horror. I mean, if there's a distinction, I would say
it's all kind of the same genre, but it's like subgenre.
Yeah, like psychological thrillers, things like that. There's one called Primal Fear.
That's old.
I don't know if you guys remember that movie. It had
from 20 years ago.
Was I born yet?
Yeah. No. Had Richard Gere and Edward Norton. And it was like a courtroom psychological thriller where Edward Norton was.
That's not a scary movie.
Accused of killing someone, but it was like a psychological thriller. I told you I don't watch scary movies.
It's not close enough. Speaking of torture movies, I hate torture movies, but Martyrs was good. Not
was torture to watch?
The actual, it was, I don't think I would watch it a second time.
As Above, So Below was pretty good. I liked that one.
Yeah. That one was more like a Da Vinci Code-ish.
Yeah, but it was a scary-ish.
Yeah.
I don't know. Shit. I don't watch scary movies.
I know you're looking around the room right now looking
I'm trying to find like books that they made into movies.
You're being me.
I know.
For video games.
Harry Potter 4.
That's not.
Oh, it terrified me. I had nightmares.
The Chronicles of Narnia, the Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Oh, my God. Okay, let Nick go then because you don't have any.
Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy.
Stop.
Oh, Jurassic Park.
Please stop.
Congo. Jurassic Park probably did count.
Yeah.
It's not
what a about Congo?
No.
That was a scary movie. No. Monkeys were killing people.
Wow. No.
Apes.
No.
Sorry. They were apes.
Cujo?
Yeah.
Cujo would count.
I do have Stephen
Cujo
King.
Cujo counts.
I have Stephen King stuff over there.
Yeah.
Stephen King counts.
Yeah. But
oh, like, I would my hope
favorite,
so.
My favorite Stephen King stuff is not horror. It's freaking Shawshank yeah. Redemption
yeah.
and The Green Mile.
Which, I can't watch The Green
oh,
Mile.
Oh, The Green Mile was so good. I read the book like four times before I watched the movie because I loved it. And then watch a movie and I'm like, oh God, it hurts. Have you seen it?
Oh yes. Oh, I understand.
Man. I tried. I got through like 5 minutes and had to turn it off.
Oh, yeah. Cause,
it's too rough.
Yeah, it's rough. Sorry, boss.
Anyway.
I'm tired, boss. I'm tired. Yeah.
Nick.
Man.
Name yes. some of yours. You're another horror fan.
Yes, please. Redeem
all right. Us. The hard part of this was limiting it to 10 even.
Well, he wanted 20.
You can go longer than that. You can go longer than that. I disagreed with yeah. a bunch of the ones you said you were going to name.
I know, but that's just only because you're wrong.
I do have really terrible taste in movies.
Yeah, I mean, right. I'm surprised you didn't put like House of Wax on there and Sorority Row. And
because those are really bad.
Those are like your
They're
favorites.
They're like guilty pleasure horror movies.
Yeah. Everyone just watched that for Paris Hilton anyway.
And I liked Gothica. Which was terrible, you guys. It was terrible.
You guys remember that Supernatural episode where they went to the wax house and it was Paris Hilton? Like, the wax figure of her was killing people?
Yeah.
That was a fun one. It was like episode.
They make a reference to House of Wax.
Because Jared Padalecki was in House
of Wax. And then Jensen Ackles is like, never saw it. And then they pan over to Jared Padalecki and he's like, "Mur? You didn't watch it?"
Good stuff.
You interrupted Nick.
I know, but keep going.
That's fine.
It was relevant.
It was. Okay, so Hellraiser 3 is one of my all-time favorites. Evil Dead. Mm-hmm. This is the one Amanda didn't like, VHS.
Right. Now, wait, which Evil Dead? The remake or the original?
Original.
Everyone. All of them.
Swallow your soul?
I even like the remake.
No. Okay.
I thought the remake was awful.
No, I thought it was okay. I especially like the chainsaw face fuck part there. God. That was real cool.
Wow.
But Evil Dead, even the original, wasn't scary. It was funny.
Well, it was because it was like cheesy.
I think in
like,
its time, it could have been scary. Because, I mean, all the movies at that time were cheesy special effects and that kind of thing. So,
so sorry.
Oh, my God. Unusable.
So unprofessional, Graham.
Totally.
Totally.
Okay, so you said VHS, which I thought was awful.
Yeah.
What else?
The Conjuring, The Stand.
Conjuring was okay.
Yeah, The Conjuring was...
Wait, The Stand, like the TV miniseries one?
Yeah. Yeah, I really like that.
That was good.
That was good.
That's adventure horror, is what I call that. In the Mouth of Madness, which was based off H.P. Lovecraft stuff.
I was going to say, that sounded familiar. Yeah.
Yeah. It Follows, which is newer. Cabin in the Woods.
It was okay.
Reanimator.
Cabin in the Woods was okay.
I really like Cabin in the Woods. The next one was Reanimator.
Okay.
I've been told to watch that, but I've never seen it.
Yeah, that's also based off of Lovecraft work. And probably my all-time favorite, Poltergeist.
Ah. The original?
They're just not scary anymore, though. That's the problem. They don't hold up.
Don't go towards the light, Caroline.
Every time
I think... for a celebrity impression.
Oh, yes. Use that.
Caroline, don't go towards the light.
Was that the little tiny gremlin woman? Yep.
Wow, no. Her name is Tangina.
Tangina.
Called her a gremlin?
Was that... You know what I'm talking about. Like,
was that a short,
was that a poltergeist?
Yeah. No, she
thanks
was,
a lot, Luke. She looks just like my grandmother.
The house.
Shut up. Or was that The Exorcist? No, I think poltergeist, I think.
Yeah, she's like, this house is clear. That's
this
her.
This house is clear. Yeah. I remember Ace Ventura doing
She's
that.
She's dead now.
I'm Wait sure on. She is. It was like 40 years ago.
No. The little girl died not long after the movie series.
I remember that.
Carol Ann.
Reading about something.
Yep.
The new one, have you seen it? It's actually really good. The remake of Poltergeist. And the little girl looks just like the original little girl. It's really creepy.
Did I watch
it? I was skeptical, but that movie turned out to be pretty good.
It's pretty good.
The interesting thing about that movie is the brother on his wall in his room had a poster for the winners of a Super Bowl years in the future. And the year in the post they can't figure, or they haven't explained why they did that. But the year in the poster and the day is when the little girl died, and the team in the poster is the actual team that won that year.
What the hell?
Creepy. Yeah, look it up. It's Poltergeist.
I'm scared.
I know. It's like three men and a baby and a ghost and
and a poster
in the background. And Wizard of Oz with the dude that hung himself.
Are we talking about football still?
Yeah.
Kind
of. What was Are you scared of football? Is that what it is? What was the movie where that guy died?
What?
The Crow.
The Crow.
Brandon Lee.
He died. Mm. And then...
Which was crazy because his dad is Bruce Lee, who died on set from a gun also.
Queen of the Damned. She died.
Well, she died in a plane crash on the way back.
Yeah.
Aaliyah. Pour one out.
She probably just didn't want to see that train wreck of a movie.
It was good. Speaking of people that died and pouring one out.
She just blows by that. It was good. Speaking of.
The guy that invented red Solo cups died 2 days ago.
A lot of people died this year.
I know.
Obviously, we've had some big ones this week.
We need to talk about real quick. Let's just mention Princess Leia and her mom.
Yeah.
Just in case for time stamping this week to show that we legit recorded this week.
Yes, it was awful.
I cried at work.
Back to back days. That's just horrible.
I'm like, I need to go home early.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Grim, do you have any scary movies that you'd like? You're not really.
I don't know if I would class it. Sure I am. I've watched a lot. I just can't remember them.
He's drunk all the time.
No, I wasn't when I watched these.
All right.
It was like 10 years ago. The Collector.
Oh, I love that one. I forgot about it. It's one of my favorites. Good job.
And the second one wasn't that bad, but I like the first one a lot better.
I didn't watch the second
one. Was that the one with Ashley Judd?
No.
What was I thinking of? Bone Collector, I think is what it was called. Anyway. See, I'm so bad at
scary Collector.
Movies.
They collect people.
Okay. Well, this guy collected bones.
Ooh. People.
I mean, I like the Hellraiser series. Is it Rose Dread?
Rose Dread?
The Stephen King movie?
Yeah, that was the house, right? There was like a TV movie.
Yes.
Did.
Yeah, that was good.
I don't remember that.
It was from one of his like short series books, short story books.
He did another series that was Kingdom Hospital. That one was really good.
I didn't see that.
I never saw that, actually.
You Sounds should watch familiar. It. It is something. It's something.
That's a glowing review.
I had to watch it like twice over just to kind of get everything.
Oh, okay. That's a better review.
And I don't rewatch stuff because I just remember it all. Like once I start watching.
You're saying a lot of contradictory things today.
Yeah.
I don't remember anything. I remember everything.
Exactly.
Well, That's why, I don't like to rewatch movies because once I start watching it, I'll remember it all, and I'm like a. But if I feel like I really like it, I'll watch it again.
I have to ask Luke if I've seen a movie before.
Sometimes.
Did I like it?
Just watch it. You'll remember right away.
A lot of the ones I watch were like cheesy '80s movies, like Lost Boys and.
They're scary-ish,
but they were like just that cheesy 80s everything. What was the one with Stephen Dorff was a kid that we talked about the other day? The Pit, I think is what it was called. The backyard, a tree split, and it opened a pit to hell, and these little gremlin things came out.
Was it called The Gate?
The Gate.
Called The Gate.
That was it. Stephen Dorff was like 7.
I loved that movie.
And he had a little tall head, I remember. It was little
awesome. I saw demons. It for the first time like 2 years ago.
They were claymation demons.
So bad. Oh,
that was a classic. I remember that one.
What about Ghoulies? Do you remember Ghoulies?
Oh, man. The wide mouths. Aren't they?
Coming out of the toilet all the time for whatever reason.
Is Gremlins considered a scary movie?
I was terrified of it.
What about a Christmas movie? Because people say that Gremlins sometimes is a Christmas movie.
It was.
See, that's like Die Hard. You know, what is it? Yeah.
There's one I do kind of remember. Like the name always sticks out to me. Happy Birthday to Me. It's like really old.
Never heard of it.
This girl ends up like killing all of her friends or something on her birthday. Hmm. Yeah.
All right.
Ooh, did you guys see the remake of Carrie? That was good.
I didn't.
No, I didn't.
Chloe.
I need
Moretz, whatever.
Yeah, that one was actually pretty good.
Yeah, that was pretty good, actually.
Didn't see that. I never saw the original.
Me either.
What?
What about Firestarter? What? I don't know if that was really a scary movie, though. That was more of a supernatural.
Wasn't Firestarter like a sequel to Carrie in some way?
No, no, no. It was Stephen King also, but it was...
So kind of.
The child had powers.
Pyrokinetic powers?
Yeah, it might have been related. Drew Barrymore was the little girl in it back then.
Oh, E.T.
Yes.
It's not a scary movie.
That was it. Elijah Wood. That wasn't him.
Like Grim Finish.
I'm finished. I'm done.
I know when Grim finishes.
Ew. Wildly inappropriate.
What? What are you talking about? I wasn't talking about that.
Did anybody?
You guys are weird.
You're weird.
Did anybody get other questions?
Awkward tone to the podcast today.
Well, that's your fault.
Oh my god!
Everybody's depressed because you said you were going to shave.
I know. That's what happens.
I don't really care.
Life is hard.
Yes, you do.
Shave it off.
You don't mean even that, your head. Grim.
Whoa, no! I can't shave that. That's too nice.
Did anybody else get?
Well,
questions?
You're not balding, so.
Nope. Not that I saw nothing like personally.
No one talks to me.
What we saw on Twitter.
They do. You just don't fucking remember.
Any Instagramming ones? No, he remembers everything once he starts to hear it.
Let me see.
Oh wait, yeah.
Well, if we read the question that you heard right now, you might remember.
No. Start saying it.
What is?
Shut up.
What is your quest?
What is your favorite color?
Exactly.
Who's your daddy, and what does he do?
No, we've covered that.
See,
it's Ron Swanson. Remember? See? Speaking of Ron Swanson, those beard products I'm using from. What's called?
Did it come with that meat press?
Dollar Beard Crib. No, the bacon press we already owned. That was. I just figured it was appropriate to have that in the picture.
For a dollar, I was gonna get it.
No, right?
No. Dollar Bacon Club.
So I got the brush, which feels great. It's like boar's hair, and it's so nice.
Was that in the box too?
Yeah, it was in the box. But it's not like a monthly thing. And then the monthly subscription you can adjust anytime you want. But I'm gonna do. I think I'm going to try. The sandalwood oil also, just to see which scent I like better. But I really like the original one. It's nice. It reminded me of Ron Swanson when I said my dad was Ron Swanson.
Have you smelled Ron Swanson?
You've sniffed? Yeah.
No, but it's what I think it's what I think he would smell like. You know, because he's always in a wood shop. And he's
all right. He's always eating meat.
Steak. Bacon. Smell.
Exactly.
It's a woodsy, bacony smell.
Like you would drink scotch and eat whiskey.
Eat whiskey.
Yeah. Drink whiskey.
Whiskey cake.
And scotch, yeah, scotch whiskey.
What is happening to you right now? Did you have a stroke?
I need steak.
I need scotch and whiskey.
Pass me the bottle. No. Yeah, it's what I feel
steak?
Like.
Steak?
He would say, yeah, I have a bottle of steak and a cube of whiskey. And... Good lord, this went off the rails.
You
need to eat a whiskey bar, you're not yourself.
He needs to eat actual food, I think is the problem.
Oh my god, that'd be a great marketing thing. Freaking whiskey. Whiskey like energy bars.
Gross.
Just add water.
I think that's it then.
What?
I encourage people to send in questions and that kind of thing. Send it to our website. Go to the website. Send us questions. Send us impersonations.
Don't forget your feet pictures for Grim.
That was a thing a long time ago.
No, it's always going, but please don't do it.
There is one thing I would like to mention that in the next year, I guess one of my resolutions is we're going to see a big change to the website.
Oh,
at some point.
What?
Yeah, I mentioned it to you, Amanda, before. We're going to try and get more. Oh, thanks.
Wow.
No.
We're
going to try and get more connection with the listeners and stuff and have stuff for them to do on there and more incentive to visit the website other than to look at our pretty pictures.
Mm, okay.
We need more feedback, too. Like, I want to hear what people like and what people don't like. Like, we get questions, but I want to know if people really
email
enjoy
is archaic
it.
Now.
Yeah,
well,
I was thinking
to
that
me.
Too.
I don't care.
We all have the tweeters.
#ConkBot, just tweet it.
I think if I had a contact form on the website, we'd get a lot of interaction. But well, that's the problem. We'd get a lot of shit mail too, and a lot of hacking attempts.
Your whole week would be like going through the fucking crap to see what's actual legit or not.
We could help.
It's the hackers that are the main problem. So
then don't put it.
Lead hacks, bro.
I'm way ahead of you. I already didn't do it.
Good job. Congratulations.
You're so proactive.
I might do a blog and put the blog entries on the website.
We could have a separate tab for your blog. And everybody could have a blog.
We talked about that too, but since you didn't remember the other part, you're not getting it.
Oh.
Just kidding. Ooh.
Busted.
Ooh. Just kidding.
That hurts.
Yeah.
That ties into what I said at the beginning of the episode. I'm only nice to people if they owe me.
What's everybody doing for New Year's? We can talk about that for a bit before we go.
We're having a party.
What?
We're having an Amiibo tournament.
What you and your lady doing?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Well, she's in Ithaca and I'm at home.
I thought you lived in Ithaca.
No. She's from Ithaca.
Oh, wait. I know this. He lives in Elmira.
Yeah. Oh, that's right. Same thing.
Are we not supposed to say that?
I don't know.
It's New York City.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to get shot walking on the street. Yeah, but you live in New York. You could be shot right now through that window back there.
That's right. It's all New York City. We've established this. Come on. There's no other cities in
New York. If I'm not supposed to say that, I am sorry. I was just like so surprised I remembered something.
No, okay. I really don't care.
We have editing permissions, remember? So
yeah.
If we need to.
Every time I remember a fact about someone, I get so excited I just blurt it out.
Your birthday is...
You know what we were going to do this week? Yeah. We were going to get to know your Nick.
Oh, yeah.
Do you have a bunch of questions?
We can do all the questions.
Save that for next one.
Yeah, we can do it next time. Yeah. But what about you, Nick? You doing anything tonight?
Not really. We're going to play some games. I've got to start moving tomorrow, so...
Yay!
Who's this week?
Congratulations.
You got a mouse in your pocket? What's going on?
Yeah. He's got slaves.
He got slaves.
Oh my God. No, like your business
Wait,
people?
Which part?
Your friends that work there?
They're coming.
The people he's
my
forcing
friends.
To...
I don't remember what part I said we to. I'm moving tomorrow, but tonight me and my friends are going to play some games here. So
nice.
I can't get rid of
he's
drunk.
Making them move.
Yeah,
make them move me.
Only half roaring drunk.
Only friend. You know your true friends when they help you move, because moving sucks.
That's
true.
It's the worst.
It is.
I don't help anyone.
Just pay for movers.
Nick, you're not anyone's true friend.
Yeah, we're not.
I have a lot of people who I'm their true friend, but. Wait, no, they're my true friend, but I'm not.
God dang. Good thing they don't listen to the podcast.
Yeah.
We're not That's moving true, ourselves goodness. Ever
no,
again.
No, we're not moving ever again.
I will
ourselves.
Pay.
That's what I said like people. 10 years ago.
Is that why you have a house?
Yeah, fucking house.
Never buy a house.
Never buy a house.
Never
seriously.
Buy a house, kids.
Well, at least not out in the country out there.
We had like four things break in this apartment this week.
Don't buy a house at all. Like,
just
if you're in an apartment
it.
And you hear a noise at night, no big deal. If you're in your house and you hear a noise, that's like thousands of dollars being ripped out of your pocket.
Yeah, literally this
soul.
This morning, like literally, I'm getting ready to make stuff for the. We're having some friends over tonight doing that Amiibo tournament that we're going to do. Having snacks, and I'm making like make up cheese balls. Well, cheese logs more than balls.
Whisky bars.
Yeah, whiskey. I made a fresh batch of whiskey bars.
Whiskey bars and cheese logs.
Yeah. I got steak drinks for everybody. And but no, so I'm getting ready to do stuff, and I have the hot water on, and I'm like, oh, it's a little like scalding. So I turn the cold on a little bit to get it, you know, to temperature where I can wash my hands, and it just stops. Like no water coming out. And I'm like,
oh, wow.
And I'm wiggling them both and nothing's coming out. I'm like, what the hell just happened?
No water leak or anything. Like it just stopped.
And the rest of our apartment was fine. All the showers and sinks and everything all working. Just that one. So we had to call them and they came right over, which is pretty cool. And
they were here last weekend.
Yeah. And last week they fixed it right away. They just replaced the faucet because they're like, oh, something broke in there, you know, like a gasket or something. And then last week, our air conditioner stopped working, and they had to replace a capacitor. So we were like a day and a half, 2 days without air conditioning.
I wouldn't hear.
You
left.
Guys are privileged, even
which,
the air conditioners.
I know. Which 75 degrees down here
On Christmas.
So we actually needed air conditioning because it got up to like 80 one day, and then
it was 84, geez. And then I left.
Yeah. So
it hit 84 in here, and I walked out.
So good thing we didn't have to, you know, pay for any of that stuff to be fixed, because we live in an apartment.
The disposal went out like last week.
Oh my god, that was like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Our garbage disposal. I got to turn it on. You hear just clank, 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 clank. I'm like, what the hell? So
it shook the whole kitchen.
So we turn it off, and I look in there.
Stick your hand in there.
Yeah, I just stuck my hand in there, and I'm like, oh my god, there's a hole in the plate where the little, you know, like the little tines are attached, you know, that are screwed in. That
no, spin. I don't know what a garbage disposal whatever. Is.
Anyway, so there's like a plate, and then there's these little blade tines thing that spin, and the plate itself was rusted through, like a hole in it, and one of the tines had come off, like. Completely off.
What are you
off.
Putting down your garbage?
No, it's just been for so, like, it's been here for years, you know, and I guess it just.
It's an old complex.
Rusted out eventually.
I'm used to a brand new apartment. It's so nice.
Yeah, so we got a brand new garbage disposal and a sink and, you know, like all this stuff, so.
Like, all that shit adds up to a lot of money if you had to pay for that.
The air conditioner is special.
Yeah, what would you have especially. Done? Especially. Yeah.
Especially.
I would have moved.
Yeah.
Abandon the house.
Just move out.
Leave it. Oh, God.
Yeah. This is why all those Americans walked out on their mortgages. Their disposals broke.
Our sink won't work. Fucking move out.
Yeah. Take your shit.
Here's the keys, bank. Fuck you.
But yeah, they're really good here about getting stuff fixed and pretty quickly. And so, yeah, no complaints.
Yeah.
Good stuff, except the neighbors.
Whoa.
You're getting a little rambly there.
Yeah. I doubt it.
I really doubt that.
Yeah.
Anyway, anything else you guys want to talk about? I didn't say anything stupid this week, did I?
I don't think so. Nothing that I remember. You know,
especially.
Especially.
Nothing notable enough to play music for.
Or whenever I called it a disposal. Instead of a disposal.
She literally just did that.
It's a good description of what it does. Is. So. That's that not can slide.
All. Well, maybe that's the problem. She thought it disposed of all. What are you putting down there?
Putting down the old forks and spoons that are dirty.
Yeah. I don't want to wash these.
No wonder it's broke.
Just get rid of these.
Yeah.
Good sound effects.
Will it blend?
Top quality.
In a disposal. That was my garbage disposal sound.
It's not even close to what it sounds like. All right. I think we're done.
Love it.
Yep.
See everybody next week. Everybody say goodbye.
Goodbye, Nick.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye. Just me. Nah, just you.
Bye, Nick.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, Graham.
Bye, Nick.
Bye.
Wow.